Hi, I'm Miles with the FOA, and there are some things about the Fisker Ocean that if you're an owner, you love. The range, the driving experience, California mode, the list goes on. But there are other things that can kind of drive you a little bit crazy. For me, the number one thing that drives me crazy are the jack points under this car. At some point, you're going to get a flat, you're going to have to rotate your tires, you're going to have to get new tires. And for some reason, the engineers at Fisker decided it was a good idea to use these plastic, flimsy, oddly shaped jack points that are very easy to break. They are difficult to use. And if you go to a tire shop, they're not going to have the exact puck that you need. So you have to bring your own. Now, there's been a few solutions proposed on what to do about this. I followed a mountain ranger tutorial about how to use epoxy to actually fill the inside of the jack points so that you make them a little bit stronger. The problem is you're lying underneath the car, you're trying to fill the jack points with chopsticks. You might do it as closely or perfectly as you possibly can, but there's always going to be a place where the epoxy doesn't fill exactly perfectly, and that creates pressure on the plastic jack points. And in my case, it actually broke the jack point. So unfortunately, I now have a broken jack point. And I was talking to an Ocean owner near me by the name of Artur about this problem. And he is really talented at working on EV conversions. He's a CAD designer and came up with a really cool solution. So Artur thought about three different scenarios that would help us Ocean owners to be able to lift our car safely. One of them is if you have the stock jack points, you haven't touched anything, you haven't done the epoxy method. He designed a really great new puck that fits inside the jack point perfectly. Here's Artur explaining the design.
Here we have original Fisker Ocean support in its original form. It's unmodified and in fairly good condition. I'm going to install this protector piece that I just printed out of ABS. You can see it's pretty nice and tight fit. Here you can see it at a little bit different angle, and you can see how it sticks out a little bit, a few millimeters beyond the rocker panel to protect it.
For damaged original Fisker jack points without epoxy, this support can even be used with these slightly damaged areas, as he shows here. In some cases, he suggests it might even be a good idea to add some glue and actually make a semi-permanent solution by inserting this jack point support into the vehicle so that no matter who lifts the car, added support is provided every single time.
It may take a few tries, but it can be done. Now you can use your jack points again.
The second design he came up with is for people like me who use the epoxy method. He made a new design of the puck that we've been using that has more stability with this ridge around the outside. So when you go to lift the car, you know that it's really secure and it's connected to the jack point and it's not going to move. And I find that it just works better. And the third option is for people like me who have a broken jack point, a way to lift the car without causing more damage to the jack point and providing really good support on lifting it. In my opinion, I think that this is a better overall solution than the epoxy method because you can use them when you need them to provide the most support to the vehicle in the area that it needs it most. Okay, so here's where you come in. We need help with all the members of the FOA community to print these new puck designs using the instructions in the description of this video below and on Thingiverse. And we need people to test these pucks on their cars and report back how they're working, if you like them, if they're working well. And as much as possible, we want as many members of FOA to have access to these pucks. So if you have a 3D printer and you can help print these for members of your community that you met at the PKC 21 meetups or people you know in your local community, that would be amazing. And we'll also open up a way for people to order them just basically at cost and shipping fees for other people who are interested in trying these out. We'll post details on Discourse, and I'll be sharing more details as well on Facebook. Reach out to us in the comments below if you're interested in supporting this, and get involved. We'd love to get as many people trying out these new pucks as possible to see how they work for your car. Thank you very much.